Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the session in conversation with Pran Nevile. Our moderator for this session is Mr. Asif Noorani. Allow me to introduce our moderator, Asif Noorani. Asif Noorani writes on culture, particularly music and literature, and reviews books. However, he says his first love is music. Renowned for his wit, he is an ardent crusader for cordial relations between India and Pakistan, conveying his viewpoint through his writings and occasionally through his talks in India, Pakistan, and the US. His first book, Tales of Two Cities, was co-authored with the well-known Indian writer Kuldeep Nayyar. His book, Mehdi Hassan, The Man and His Music, was published in 2008. In 2012, he revised and updated Journey Through Pakistan. This was a brief introduction of our moderator. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. I'm glad that my wife is not here because I don't let her know that music is my first love. So, otherwise my safety would have been in doubt. Anyway, it's a great honor, can you hear me? It's a great honor to interview Mr. Pran Nevile, who has been a distinguished foreign service worker in India. He worked with distinction in the United Nations, and he wrote some very interesting books. So, Mr. Pran Nevile has been a great draw in Lahore after the elections. So, okay, we say you've written 14 books, but 13 have been launched. Is that correct?
That's right.
And you started rather late, but you have made up by, rather late means you started in the, when you were in the 70s, when you retired from government service. My question to you is, someone asked the great filmmaker from your country, when I say your country, I'm a bit confused because Lahore is in Pakistan, so Lahore is also your vatan, but anyway, coming to Satyajit Ray was once asked which was his favorite film. So Ray, in his characteristic baritone, said, let me put it like this, that if I were to make all my films again, I would make Charulata just as I had made it earlier. So now my question is, which is your favorite book of yours?
I would like to answer in my different way. You quoted Satyajit Ray. I would like to quote Malka Itarannam Noor Jahan, who was known as Bulbul-e Hind in India. When somebody asked her, which is your most favorite song? She answered, all songs are my children. I don't make any distinction whatsoever.
So you've changed your mind since this morning. In the morning when I was interviewing you for Dawn, you said you voted in favor of Lahore, A Sentimental Journey. It
depends on the audience.
Women are supposed to be fickle-minded. They change their mind so early, but I'm surprised that you have changed your mind so quickly. Anyway, all children are dear to them, but there is some child, one child, who is more equal than others, kind of a thing. And in the morning you said Lahore, A Sentimental Journey was your favorite. My question is,
that was the starting point of my career. That is why I told you I became an author because of the success which I had in my first attempt at writing. So Lahore remains for me the beginning of my career, and also which inspired me to continue writing.
So it was your first love?
Well, you can put it like that.
Okay. So it's your first love.
Because you don't try to distinguish between the beloveds.
Oh, you don't. But now coming to Lahore, I have met many friends in India who have said that Lahore, they yearn for Lahore. Everyone, Pakistanis, when they go abroad, they say they are very nostalgic about Lahore. Now the question is, as they said, jinne Lahore ni vekhya ho, janam hi nahi paya, something like that. Pardon my broken Punjabi, but what is it in Lahore which is not there in any other cities that makes it people so nostalgic about it?
Lahore defies definition. Lahore is a city that has to be seen and felt. So it cannot be compared to any other city because it is so unique that no one has been able to describe it.
In 1964, when I went to Bombay, I met a Sardarji taxi driver, and he, when I started speaking in my broken Punjabi, he said, "Tusi Punjabi bol de ho, galt bol de ho, fir bhi saadi zubaan hai, mainu bahut khushi hui." To maine kaha, "Fir aap kahan ke?" पूछा कि कहाँ से आए हो, मैंने कहा गुजरांवाला से. आहा, बड़ा अच्छा शहर है, बड़ा वड्डा शहर. और गाड़ी चलाते चलाते वो पीछे देख रहा है, मुझे डर ये था कि कहीं मार ना दे वो. तो बहरहाल एनीवे, उसको गुजरांवाला बहुत पसंद आया, आपको लाहौर बहुत पसंद आया, लेकिन फिर भी लाहौर में कोई, जैसे आपने सही कहा, इट डिफाइज डेफिनेशन, इट इज़ यूनिक. चलें आपकी बात मान लेते हैं, आप हमारे मेहमान हैं. Now, coming to, you have been writing about the Raj, you've written something like 14 books, and you write about the Raj, you write about the Notch Girls, you write about Lahore, but it seems that you are caught in a time warp. आप आगे नहीं बढ़े, हालांकि आप इन एन इंटरव्यू यू वंस सेड दैट आई एम वन ऑफ दोज हु एडमायर एंड अप्रिशिएट द यंगर जनरेशन. आई नेवर ट्राई टू सर्मनाइज एंड से माय डेज वर बेटर. ओ नो, दैट्स द पास्ट एंड दिस इज द प्रेजेंट. आई एंजॉय मिक्सिंग विद द यंगर जनरेशन. सो हाउ इज इट दैट यू ओनली राइट अबाउट द पास्ट, नॉट अबाउट द प्रेजेंट?
I learn from the younger generation to get inspired, to learn more. That has nothing to do with my themes chosen for writing.
Okay. Now, when you talk about it, let me recall, since you are a man of many facets, you are a scholar of art, culture and history. Lahore, a sentimental journey, I would call it a highly readable history of Lahore, and it's, as someone who spent my childhood in Lahore after partition, I find this book very absorbing, and I'm sure I am reminded of a friend of yours called Asif Siddiqui, who was so inspired by your book on Lahore that he wrote Banarsi Karachiite. Can you tell me something about that?
You see, it was I think more than 15 years ago. He had read my book and then he was inspired to write, which he puts down in his introduction and preface of his book, that he was inspired by my book. Then he writes that book, gets it published in India, and makes contact with me and requests me to launch that book. I launched his book in the presence of Kuldeep Nayyar. He had invited him also. And that book is very interesting, I should say, because he was only 2 years old when he left Banaras with his parents. And then rest of the life he was in Karachi and England and all that, you see. His wife is from Kapurthala, Punjabi speaking. He is Urdu speaking. But They're very wonderful couple. They know my family members, everybody, and we are in constant touch. I get a telephone call or email from him all the time. See, he knows that I'm in Islamabad, even that, you see.
Okay.
He's in London.
But you can't make a comparison, you see, because you spent, you were in your 20s when you left Lahore, and he was just 2.
I don't compare his book with mine. I only say that he was just inspired to record what he felt in living in Karachi and having stories of Banaras from his elders, from parents, like that.
Your next book, your 14th book, which would be launched after election, if not mistaken, was based on your research in the US Library of Congress. And would you like to tell us about that?
You see, in fact, it took me 7 years to write my book, Notch Girls of India, sumptuously illustrated book, and the first book on the subject. For that, I had to do a lot of research in the museums and galleries all over the world. So my research took me to England, to Aga Khan Gallery in Geneva, to America, in the US museums there, Peabody Museum, and the Yale Center of British Art. So all this, I collected the visual material to enrich the narrative and made it a very attractive coffee table book.
You came to Lahore after 50 years, the gap of 50 years. And you had only pleasant thing to write about. You didn't write about the partition riots and how your family was displaced. Would you like to speak about how your family...
I never speak of politics, nor anything about the partition, sad or good or nothing. I don't want to even...
I just want
to forget about it as an episode of history, not to be paid much attention.
But
because both sides have paid for it, and Punjabis have paid for the independence of creation of these two countries.
But don't you think that it was partly because of the line that was drawn rather late, what was to be in, what part will be in India, what part will be in Pakistan, by Radcliffe? It was drawn late, and it was not even known what part of will be in Pakistan and what part of Punjab will be in India.
As I told you, this is a subject on which I don't discuss and don't say anything, because this is, for me, it is something which people are, so many scholars, other people who are doing research, writing, exchanging notes, holding debates. I keep myself away, devoting my time to art and culture, the great melody makers of Punjab, the great singers from Punjab. So my attention is devoted to that field rather than this.
Okay, so you've written a book on Sehgal. It was a coffee table book, and this book is available here outside. You have signed copies at the Liberty Books. It's called K.L. Sehgal, The Definitive Biography. It was commissioned on, if I'm not mistaken, on the 100th
centenary
of K.L. Sehgal. In your articles, you have written about Suraiya, you have written about Noor Jahan. You have not written about non-Punjabis. You have not written about Lata Ji. You have not written about Kishore Kumar, who was more versatile than K.L. Sehgal. You have not even written about Muhammad Rafi, who like Asha Bhosle, was the most versatile singer we had. And if you listen to Soja Rajkumari in the voice of Lata Mangeshkar, then you would be more moved. How come you only write about the Punjabis? And I know religious reason is not there, because you've been appreciative of Suraiya and you think very, very highly of Noor Jahan. How would you defend yourself against this charge?
In the subcontinent, there has been no actor-singer of the caliber of Malka Itranam Noor Jahan. Actor-singer. These playback singers, whoever they are, Suraiya is also actor-singer. So playback singers are different for me. So when I say write about Suraiya, I write about Kanan Bala, I write about Noor Jahan, and K.L. Sehgal is different because so far I have not written about the playback singer.
Lata happens to be. What about Pankaj Malik?
Yes.
Pankaj Malik was
actor and singer.
So you feel that a singer should be an actor to appeal to you?
No. I write of that generation, of that period, when actors, singers were the superstars or the stars. I continue to live in the past, you can
say
that.
No, but by 47, playback singing had become popular. And you found, and also later on, Noor Jahan gave up playback, gave up acting. She stuck to playback singing. So how would you defend your approach to that?
She had to go to playback singing for economic reasons. The moment color televisions came, she was singing those very songs with such glamour and glitter on the TV. When the color TV was there, she started her Tarandram program, which people just long to see that.
You have written five of your books have been coffee table books, Notch Girl of India, An Indian Woman in the Raj, Behind the Veil. Then Sehgal was initially a coffee table book, it was published by the Ministry of Culture in India. Then you've written about Marvels of Indian Painting, Rise and Demise of Company School, and then Raj Revisited. Theek hai?
Yes.
It's correct.
Five coffee table books.
Five coffee table books. Aapne apni kitab mein तमंचा जान नाम की एक गाने वाली का जिक्र किया और इस तरीके से जिक्र किया कि मुझे लगा कि यू हैड अ क्रश ऑन हर. और ठीक है, क्रश तो होना चाहिए. आप पहली दफ़ा जब आए तो तमंचा जान से मिले और आप भी बहुत, आपकी आंखों में भी शायद आंसू आ गए होंगे, उसकी भी आंखों में आंसू आ गए. अब तो वो मर गई, तो क्या आपने उसके मज़ार पे हाजिरी दी? क्या फूल चढ़ाए?
मरने वाले मरते हैं लेकिन फना होते नहीं, ये हकीकत में कभी हमसे जुदा होते नहीं.
वाह 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 वाह. आपकी किताब जो थी लाहौर पर, वो इतनी बिकी, यहाँ पर भी बहुत ज़्यादा बिकी और ऑक्सफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी प्रेस ने उसे छापा, तो वो फिर ख़त्म हो गई. और मेरी दो कॉपीज़ जो मैंने ख़रीदी थी, वो भी कोई उठा के ले गया. और उसके जो बिल है वो मैं आपको पेश करने वाला हूँ कि आप इसको मुझे जो फाइनेंशियल लॉस हुआ है उसका कुछ थोड़ा बहुत वो सहारा दें. और वो किताब अब क्या पोजीशन है? क्या अब पेंगुइन ने छापी दोबारा?
पेंगुइन तो छाप रहा है, रीप्रिंट कर रहा है.
हाँ.
पेंगुइन 2006 में उन्होंने छापी थी, पहले हार्पर कॉलन ने छापी, उसके पहले एलाइड ने छापी. ये पेंगुइन अब तक जब ख़त्म होने से पहले ही वो रीप्रिंट करते हैं. आप ऑक्सफोर्ड यूनिवर्सिटी प्रेस तीन साल से आउट ऑफ प्रिंट है, लेकिन यू हैव योर ओन रीजंस नॉट टू रीप्रिंट इट.
आई सी. तो ये नॉच गर्ल्स से आपको कोई खास लगाव कैसे था?
नो, परफॉर्मिंग आर्ट्स, परफॉर्मिंग आर्टिस्ट, आई हैव गॉट ग्रेट फैसिनेशन फॉर परफॉर्मिंग आर्ट्स. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई वाज इंस्पायर्ड टू राइट ए बुक ऑन दैट, बिकॉज आई थॉट that right. in the subcontinent, the performing arts did not get their due, especially after the British rule. And I wanted to, put the record straight by giving the whole history of the performing artists.
आपने बड़े खूबसूरत अंदाज से कहा था 2007 में इंटरव्यू जब छपा आपका रूट्स आर वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट बट इवन बर्ड्स गो बैक टू द नेस्ट इन द इवनिंग एंड द सेम इज इक्वली ट्रू फॉर दोज नाउ सेटल्ड इन पाकिस्तान एंड हु थिंक अबाउट लुधियाना और जयपुर in the same vein. You have a command over the language in the sense that you have make people, you convey your emotions very, very successfully, which very few people do. So, क्या आप अपनी बेगम साहिबा से भी इसी तरीके से गुफ्तगू करते थे जैसे आप इमोशनल तरीके से लिखते हैं?
देखिए बेगम साहिबा जब मैंने उन दोनों में लव मैरिज की जबकि एक किस्म की सिर्फ थिएटरों में होती थी तो दैट वाज वे बैक इन 1947 और बहुत कम लोग होंगे हु मैरिड द सेम गर्ल ट्वाइस विच आई डिड
हाउ
आई फर्स्ट हैड द सिविल मैरिज इन दिल्ली देन आई माय फादर ब्रॉट बोथ ऑफ अस टू लाहौर एंड वी हैड द फुल सेरेमनी राइट from the railway platform till our house in Nisbet Road with Sony's band in five tongas, six tongas, and that was the fun we had.
So, this must be early 47.
47.
Because उसके बाद तो फिर पाकिस्तान
बस बस ठीक that was her last visit to Lahore.
Is she alive?
No, she unfortunately
when
passed
when did
away.
She pass away?
Last year.
Last year. She couldn't come to Lahore?
She was bedridden for more than 10-15 years.
Oh, but your grandson came here.
Yes.
And his wife also came here.
Yes, yes.
And that's how they came to see your favorite city. And is that correct?
And also attend the launching ceremony of my book on Lahore, which OUP published in 2007, October. And my friend Asif Siddiqui came from Karachi all the way and organized a big tea party for all the guests who had been invited.
What was his profession, Asif Siddiqui?
He's a banker, micro banker or something.
Microfinance.
Yes, micro.
And he's no longer in Pakistan?
No, he has his house in Karachi, but his two children are studying in England, so he is now living
he's
in
a
London.
Retired banker.
Not a retired, he's very active.
What bank does he work for?
Pardon?
Kaun si bank mein hai wo?
Bank nahi, he has his own investment advisor, so many things.
I see. So, well, it's been such a pleasure talking to you. And main aakhir mein ye to kahunga, Allah kare zor qalam aur zyada, balki ye bhi kahunga, कि अल्लाह करे ज़ोरे कदम और ज़्यादा ताकि आप लाहौर पाकिस्तान आते रहें लेकिन मेरी दरख्वास्त ही है कि अपने कदमों का रुख जो है कभी कराची की तरफ भी तो मोड़ के देख लेना वहाँ भी तो आपके चाहने वाले काफ़ी हैं आपकी किताब पढ़ी गई है और वहाँ लाहौरी भी सेटल्ड हैं तो क्या आप हमें मौका नहीं देंगे
मैं ज़रूर आऊँगा आप अमीना सईद जी को कहिए कि नेक्स्ट जब लिटरेरी फेस्टिवल कराची में करें कम से कम मुझे अपने ऑथर को तो बुलाएं
सही बात है और किसी को कोई सवाल करना है तो पूछ लें जी एक किताब तो केएल सैगल की तो किताब मिल रही है ना
प्राण साहब की लाहौर सेंटिमेंटल जर्नी उसकी बहुत लाहौर में डिमांड है और हम बार बार अमीना साहिबा से कह रहे हैं कि वो उसको रीप्रिंट करवाएं और जिसमें उन्होंने एक खास चैप्टर ऐड किया है फॉर लाहौरी
आप ऐसे कीजिए अमीना सैयद साहिबा को सबसे ज़्यादा पायरेट्स ने नुकसान पहुँचाया है तो किसी पायरेट से कहिए कि छपाई की तैयारी करें तो अमीना सैयद फ़ौरन छाप देंगी यही एक तरीका
अगर अगर कुछ अरसा और ना छापी तो लाहौर में मेरे दोस्त कहते हैं हम जेरोक्स करके इसको सर्कुलेट करेंगे
ये बात तो सही है हाँ और any other question
so first of all welcome to Islamabad
sorry
I'm welcoming him to Islamabad
आपके मुंह के करीब
अच्छा मैं बस सिर्फ आपकी जुबानी थोड़ा सा सुनना चाह रही थी because I know you share the common love for Lahore with the late Mr. Khushwant Singh and among other things you must have shared with him and also I'm sure a friendship so a few words that you can speak about him today so we can hear a little bit about him
certainly I'll
aapki zubani
because Khushwant Singh was my guru and in fact before I wrote my book on Lahore I wrote a couple of articles which were later became chapters and I showed them to Khushwant Singh my book comes out in 93 January and these articles I wrote in 1990 in a very men's magazine as they call adult magazine it was Debonair published from Bombay so my one article was Fazal the Ace Pimp of Lahore the second was Zinda Naach Wa Gaana so when he read both of them he said Pran continue this is the best thing you are doing writing for the amusement of the people so that encouraged me to write and when my book was complete it was published I took first copy to him and the same evening he wrote the review of that he was the first person to write the review of my book after that my second book Notch Girls love stories from the Raj which I have you have got a copy isn't it love stories from the Raj
ji ji
no that also is not available but if you wanted liberty books can organize that
wo import karne wale liberty books aur lahore mein to unki branch hai hai karachi yahan bhi hogi lekin aap kl sehgal ki bhi kitab kharid lijiye aur agar aapke paas paise kam hai to meri kitab kharid lijiye
to ye jo kitab thi love stories from the raj it was Khushwant Singh who went through the manuscripts and he recommended to the penguin books he was their consultant advisor in fact he was instrumental in introducing me to the penguin books who have international network for my book love stories from the raj it has gone into 5 reprints since then still it is selling so my show that few years ago 4-5 years ago penguin books asked me to add some more 2-3 stories so I added some more 2-3 stories it's when the first edition came they priced it at 125 rupees now they are selling it almost 300-400 rupees
so
he introduced me to that book now further on he seldom went out to launching functions but in 1996 my book Launch Girls of India he enjoyed reading it so much that he agreed to launch it come to the function and the function was also to his taste it was reading from the book and a dance performance by one of the famous dancers of Delhi followed by a cocktail that was Notch Girls of India how the publication was celebrated and continued in fact just before his demise last time when I came to Lahore I met him on I think on 18th or 19th February when I came for the literary festival I asked him any message for your friends in Lahore he said well Pran they're all dead and gone and I am also ready to go then he's Ghalib he said wo kya naam दिल को खुश रखने को गालिब ये ख्याल अच्छा है वो है ना
दिल के बहलाने को गालिब ये ख्याल
नहीं दिल को खुश रखने सुनते हैं जो नहीं जन्नत
हमने माना
नहीं नहीं वो नहीं है
हमने माना जन्नत की हकीकत लेकिन
दिल
के बहलाने को गालिब
दिल के खुश रखने को गालिब एनीवे
पाकिस्तान में उन्होंने खुश बहलाने कहा हिंदुस्तान में उन्होंने
खुश रखने को गालिब तो मैंने उसका जवाब दिया, मैंने कहा सुनते हैं जो बहिश्त की तारीफ सब दुरुस्त, लेकिन खुदा करे वो तेरी जलवागाह हो।
क्या हुआ?
तो ही वॉज वेरी अम्यूज्ड एंड आई हैड टू बिकॉज ऑफ हिज हार्ड ऑफ हियरिंग आई हैड टू राइट एंड देन एनी वे इट वॉज आई स्पेंट एन आवर विद हिम हैड ए ड्रिंक ऑल्सो विद हिम एंड व्हेन आई विद इन ए मंथ ही पास्ड अवे।
देयर वॉज अनदर पर्सन अबाउट हुम यू रोट Prakash Tandon,
yes,
who wrote that lovely book, Punjab Through the Centuries.
That's right.
So, do you remember that?
He was my boss when I was resident director in Moscow of the State Trading Corporation of India. He was the chairman. He was very fond of me, so much so that he has written the foreword of this book, Love Stories from the Raj.
Thank you very much. We must give him a warm round of applause. Thank you very much, Mr. Pran Nevile. And next time, we hope you will be in Lahore and Karachi.
I would like to conclude that both of us have enjoyed this session more than the audience, and the audience is always welcome. Number two, the performing artists, they enjoy whether they are dancing or singing as much as the audience enjoys. Thank you.
Thank you very much.